In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my day. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
It is Wednesday, the 9th of November, 2022. 32nd week in ordinary time, and today we celebrate the feast of the dedication of the Lateran Basilica, the mother of all churches, the Archbasilica of St. John Lateran. And in fact, this is the oldest and highest ranking of the four major basilicas that we have in Rome, known as Papal Basilicas. These papal basilicas are St. John Lateran, which is the highest of all, and then St. Peter's Basilica, where the tomb of St. Peter is, and that is what we call the Vatican. The administration is done from there, but that is not the cathedral of the Pope. Then we have the Basilica of St. Paul, where the tomb of St. Paul is found, and at the center of Rome, near the central train station, we have Mary Major. These are the four major basilicas. But the Basilica of St. John Lateran is the cathedral of the Diocese of Rome, the official ecclesiastical seat of the Holy Father, the Bishop of Rome, the Pope. Many people think St. Peter's Basilica is the cathedral of the Pope, but no, it is John Lateran. The Basilica is also called the Church of Holy Savior or the Church of St. John the Baptist. In ancient Rome, this was the church where everyone was baptized. It was built in the time of Constantine when Christianity became the state religion and was consecrated by Pope Sylvester in 324. For your information, this is the mother of all churches. There was no other church building before that time. People were worshiping in homes. People were having small chapels for prayer. But the first basilica, the mother of all churches, is Lateran Basilica. And when you go to Rome, you haven't seen that basilica, you have not yet visited Rome. Participating in the proclamation of the word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members: Charles Piston Vandy from Freetown, Sierra Leone, celebrating his birthday today, takes for us the first reading. Felicity Roymen from Namanga, Kenya, who celebrated her birthday on the 6th of this month, takes for us the responsorial psalm. Joan Mutonga from Entebbe, Uganda, celebrating her 30th birthday today, takes for us the second reading. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Tom Rasare, who celebrated his birthday yesterday from Kisumu Archdiocese in Kenya. Let us pray. O God, who from living and chosen stones prepares an eternal dwelling for your majesty, increase in your church the spirit of grace you have bestowed, so that by new growth your faithful people may build up the heavenly Jerusalem. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. I saw water running from the temple, and all those to whom the water came were saved. A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel, chapter 47, verses 1 to 2, 8 to 9 and 12. In those days, the angel brought me back to the door of the temple, and behold, water was issuing from below the threshold of the temple towards the east, for the temple faced east, and the water was flowing down from below the right side of the threshold of the temple, south of the altar. Then he brought me out by way of the north gate and led me round on the outside to the outer gate that faces towards the east. And the water was coming out on the right side. And he said to me, "This water flows towards the eastern region and goes down into the Arabia. And when it enters the stagnant waters of the sea, the water will become fresh. And wherever the river goes, every living creature which swarms will live. And there will be very many fish, for this water goes there, that the waters of the sea may become fresh. So everything will live where the river goes. And on the banks, on both sides of the river, there will grow all kinds of trees for food. Their leaves will not wither, nor their fruit fail, but they will bear fresh fruit every month, because the water for them flows from the sanctuary. Their fruit will be for food, and their leaves for healing." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Psalm 46, 2 to 3, 5 to 6, 8 to 9. Response is taken from Psalm 46, verse 5. And the response is, "The waters of a river give joy to God's city, the holy place, the dwelling of the Most High."
The waters of the river give joy to God's city, the holy place, the dwelling of the Most High.
God is for us a refuge and strength, an ever-present help in time of distress. So we shall not fear though the earth should rock, though the mountains quake to the heart of the sea.
The waters of the river give joy to God's city, the holy place, the dwelling of the Most High.
The waters of the river give joy to God's city, the holy place, the dwelling of the Most High. God is within. It cannot be shaken. God will help it at the dawning of the day.
The waters of the river give joy to God's city, the holy place, the dwelling of the Most High.
The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold. Come and behold the works of the Lord, the awesome deeds he has done on earth.
The waters of the river give joy to God's city, the holy place, the dwelling of the Most High.
Second reading. You are God's temple. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 3, verses 9c to 11, 16 to 17. Brethren, you are God's building. According to the commission of God given to me, like a skilled master builder, I laid a foundation, and another man is building upon it. Let each man take care how he builds upon it. For no other foundation can anyone lay than that which is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Do you not know that you are God's temple and that God's Spirit dwells in you? If anyone destroys God's temple, God will destroy him. For God's temple is holy, and that temple you are. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
John chapter 2, verse 13 to 22. The Passover of the Jews was at hand, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. In the temple, he found those who were selling oxen and sheep and pigeons, and the money changers at their business. And making a whip of cords, he drove them all with the sheep and oxen out of the temple. And he poured out the coins of the money changers and overturned their tables. And he told those who sold the pigeons, take these things away. You shall not make my father's house a house of trade. His disciples remembered that it was written, Zeal for your house will consume me. The Jews then said to him, What sign have you to show us for doing this? Jesus answered them, Destroy this temple, and in 3 days I will raise it up. The Jews then said, It has taken 46 years to build this temple, and will you raise it up in 3 days? But he spoke of the temple of his body. When therefore he was raised from the dead, his disciples remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and the word which Jesus had spoken, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Happy feast of the dedication of the Lateran Basilica. And many of you may be wondering, why should we be celebrating a church that is far away from us? Why should we be celebrating a church that we may not even see in our lives? It is because of the importance of this church. This church reminds us that God decided to have a dwelling, to make a dwelling among men. Because whichever denomination you belong to, you have to acknowledge that at one point there was a church, the first church that was ever built. And this is the Lateran Basilica that was consecrated in 324. From 324, other churches have come up, but this was the first of the churches. And in meditating on the Lateran Basilica, we want to meditate on the church that we are. The church is the place where God dwells. The church is the place where blessings flow from. The first reading of today tells us of the exile experience. The people of Israel are in exile. A promise of the release has come. And Cyrus, king of Persia, has even promised that he's going to help in the construction of the new temple. Cyrus even gave part of his wealth to help in the reconstruction of that temple. A pagan. And prophet Ezekiel saw something that was going to happen after that reconstruction of the temple. Water was going to flow from the sanctuary, and that water was going to be a source of life for everyone. You know what water means? Water means life. Water is what we find at the beginning of creation when God was about to create his spirit over the waters. Because water brings life. A kind of recreation is done by water. And from the temple, there was a river flowing that went into the Alaba, that went into the Dead Sea, where everything was polluted, and it made the Dead Sea, which is 24.6% salt, to have life. In that sea, no life is found. But the water that comes from the sanctuary makes even the polluted water to be refreshed. The polluted water to be less polluted. Oh, this is nice. I like it. You know why I like it? Because it is telling me of the role that I have as the temple of the living God. This is not just referring to any physical temple. It is referring to all of us who are the temple of the living God. If you are the temple of the living God, there is water that comes from you. The water that makes our polluted world be refreshed. The water that makes everything that has died to come back to life. We are living in a world that requires this water to come from us. Christians are this living water. Christians carrying Christ in their bodies must bring life to the polluted world, where everything is okay, where everything is allowed. Christians have a task of refreshing our world today, of making our world a better world. But we must allow the water of goodness, the water of virtue, to flow from our sides. People must see, wherever we go, life in abundance. People must see that Christians have a task of reducing pollution in our world today. There is pollution of corruption in our world today. There is pollution of allowing moral laxity in our world today. And we have a task of making sure wherever we go, something changes. If I am a Christian and I'm working in that company where everything is okay, everything is allowed, people must notice my presence. I am supposed to make clean what is dirty, what is polluted. Remember, we are God's temple. That is exactly what we hear in the second reading of today, Paul writing to the Corinthian community that was living in a kind of polluted society. Everything was allowed. People were going on the mountain to worship the god of sex. People were getting involved in everything and anything. Like that pastor I heard about from Tanzania in Kenya, if the social media may be saying the truth, who is allowing anything bad to happen in that church? It was the case at the time of Paul for the Corinthian community. They were going to sacrifice to the god of sex. They degraded their own bodies. And Paul had to remind them that they are supposed to restore dignity. They are supposed to reduce that pollution in the society by being temples of the living God. We are temples of the living God, and being temples of the living God, we are not just going to allow anything to be right in our society. We are going to make sure what is right is upheld and what is evil is condemned. Jesus condemns doing business in the house of God. He chases those people and he's trying to say, he's condemning you doing business in his house. If you are the temple of the living God, then don't use that temple for business. That temple is not supposed to be used for business. And I know you understand this. You, as a believer, baptized, the temple of the living God should not use your body for prostitution. As a believer, the temple of the living God should not go into transgender activities because you are transgressing the temple of the living God. We want to say, Lord, I know you have taught us well. I know you have shown us the true path and how to live dignified lives. We are going to be that living water to others in order for people to understand what it takes to belong to you. We give glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Wednesday to you, and happy feast of the dedication of the Lateran Basilica.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I'm desperate for you. My day.